This is the first time I will use the provided reviewer's guide extensively, and Corsair explains everything clearly in it, so I see no point in trying to explain the new HXI shift line entirely on my own, except for one crucial fact that is not highlighted in the reviewer's guide. The HXI shift members don't have a minus 12 volt rail, which is a remnant of the past, not offering anything. On the contrary, it affects efficiency. This is a good call. The first shift PSU with Cybernetics Platinum Certified Efficiency. It's the first Corsair power supply with a built-in IQ Link system hub. It's not a pass-through, as the system hub is internal to the PSU, so IQ Link systems don't need to mount a system hub inside the case. This helps system builders by eliminating the need for a 6-pin PCI Express power connector. Although it is internal to the PSU, it is the same system hub as before, supporting up to 24 devices across two channels. Differences between HXI Shift and HXI. HXI Shift has side-mounted connectors. HXI Shift has a built-in IQ Link system hub. HXI Shift has a native 12-volt 2x6 connector cable with two connectors on HX1500i Shift. HXI uses standard Type 4 connectors and Type 4 to 12-volt 2x6 cables. HXI Shift has outlines around the connectors to reduce confusion about connector types. The HX1500i Shift includes dual 12-volt 2x6 connectors for multi-GPU builds, and HXI Shift uses flexible Type 5 cables, and HXI uses Type 4 cables. The exterior design stands out from the crowd thanks to the shifted modular panel, perforations at the fan grille, and the unit's exhaust side. Around the back, where you typically find the modular panel in standard PSUs, there are the IQ RS4 8.5 Type-C and tachometer output ports. You have to use Corsair's IQ software to talk to the power supply. Thankfully, this application has been vastly improved through time, although there's still room for improvement. From IQ, you can monitor power settings, toggle between single and multiple 12-volt rails on the fly, and also create custom fan speed profiles. CWT provides the platform, which is semi-digital since the primary side and part of the secondary are handled by digital controllers. Only the minor rails and 5SB use analog controllers. Otherwise, this platform would be fully digital. The HX1000i uses a half-bridge topology on its primary side, while the higher-end models use a full-bridge topology, which is better suited to high power output. The heat sinks on the primary side are large enough for a modern, efficient platform, while those on the secondary side are tiny. CWT typically uses small heat sinks on the secondary sides of its high-end implementations to lower production costs and save valuable PCB space. The build quality is high overall, as expected in such an expensive PSU. All parts are high quality, including Infineon FETs and pure Japanese capacitors from Chemicon and Rubicon. The cooling fan is also the typical NR140P, using a fluid dynamic bearing. Although CWT started producing its own fans, Corsair still wants even higher performance and quality. Load regulation is within 1% on all primary rails. I would like to see a tighter load regulation at 12-volt, given the digital control. Ripple suppression is good overall. The 12-volt rails performance is dead low in this test, transient response ATX version 3.1. The average efficiency is high enough at normal loads, but it is not at light or super light loads. The average efficiency meets the Cybernetics Platinum criteria. The FFC converter needs tuning for higher PF readings. The digital controllers are not appropriately utilized in this aspect. The PSU's average noise output is dead low at the default settings. You can adjust the fan speed profile to your liking if you connect the PSU to your system through the IQ application. The fan's passive operation lasts for very short periods because of how we apply the loads, first increasing the combined load on the minor rails, then increasing the 12-volt rails load. Nevertheless, the fan's noise remains below 10 decibels at up to 515 watt at 12-volt. The 25 dBA mark is passed at 750 watt, while the fan's noise exceeds 30 decibels for a very short period. Overall, the fan speed profile is highly relaxed. The overall performance is competitive if you exclude the Pizzius price, which is pretty stiff because of the extra IQ Link hardware. That said, the plain HX1000i offers better performance and costs way less. I conducted the protection features evaluation with the PSU at its stock settings without having it connected to a system. The 12-volt rail is conservatively set, but I would like to see a larger difference between standard and high operating temperatures. The minor rails have highly set OCP triggering points, and to make matters worse, OCP is set higher at 5 volt under high temperatures, while it remains similar at 3.3 volt. Under high temperatures, the PSU is stressed more, so naturally OCP triggering points should drop. The overpowered triggering points are not correctly set, since the triggering points are identical under standard and high temperatures. They are conservative, at least, and the remaining essential protection features are present and functioning well, and this platform includes fan failure protection. In case the fan is not connected or not working correctly, the PSU shuts down after a short period. The Corsair HX1000i Shift is expensive at $340, and given that most of the internal components are the same as the plain HX1000i, I suspect the extra IQ Link hardware is to blame for the higher production cost. Performance-wise, it loses a bit to the HX1000i, and I expected higher performance given the semi-digital platform, which needs tuning to deliver even tighter load regulation, higher PF readings, and better transient response at 12V under high loads. Whether the HX1000i Shift is worth your money depends on if you will use its integrated IQ Link system hub, which lets you connect and control up to 24 compatible devices. This hub alone costs $60, and making the necessary changes to include it inside the PSU further increases the cost. You should also consider whether you can use the HX1000i Shift's side modular panel before you buy it. In other words, check whether it is compatible with your chassis and offers better cable routing and management. All in all, the HX1000i Shift offers decent overall performance, but I expected more given its higher price, about $100 more than the HX1000i. That is all, guys. Bye-bye.